we're trying to inspire mass participation in consumer recycling of electronics, and we do it by providing convenience, putting it in your daily or weekly path so that it's not a special trip, and then incentivizing it, paying you for what it's worth. That is a lot, and that number will grow very rapidly as we expand. These machines are marching out of San Diego, out of the factory, at the rate of 2 or 3 or 4 per day. So we're growing very rapidly and getting them placed all around the country. A little over 400 machines now in 25 states. Well, if you think about, put it where it's convenient for people to get to, and people go to malls quite often. They go to grocery stores is another target for us. They go to big box retailers. We're even thinking about some public transit places where there's lots of traffic. So where do people go mostly? And let's put it in their path as often as we can be in their path so it's easy for them. We're buying 170 million phones a year, and it doesn't take very long before you get to 1 billion. And most people haven't recycled many of those yet. And so how do you inspire consumers to get those back in the system, get them in the hands of people who want to use them, give them a second life or a third life, you know, or recycle the materials if they're too old? We have created the worst place for a bad guy to sell a stolen phone and the best place for a stolen phone to end up if you're a victim, somebody stole your phone, because if we find it, we're going to give it back to you for free. Yeah, it's actually a problem created by technology itself, and we're using technology to solve it, cleaning up our own mess, if you will.